Welcome back. One final point before we go tonight. A feminist writer at The New Yorker named Helen Rossner recently went on a Twitter rant about how men can be better feminists. The fundamental premise of her rant assumes that all men are sexist and all men are at fault for Harvey Weinstein's disgusting behavior. I would like to address a few of her points, because isn't that why feminists spew this nonsense, so I can shoot it down? Ms. Rossner starts by saying, if you are a man unsure of what to do to support women right now in your daily life, beyond, like, not sexually harassing us, some starting points. So first of all, Ms. Rossner assumes all men sexually harass women, even the men that don't. This is why when feminists claim that they are not man haters, nobody believes them. Then Ms. Rossner says to men, in order to be a better feminist, they need to overcome your own transphobia. Trans women are women. Accept the lived truth of NB and GNC people, whether or not they are women. Well, even Ms. Rossner can't decide whether these people are women or not. She's so busy virtue signaling, she literally trips over her own premise. The thing is, men are men and women are women. It doesn't matter if you cut off your genitals, you're still a man if that's how you were born. I don't say this to offend anyone. I'm a full supporter of allowing people the liberty to live their own lives how they choose. It's none of my business. But stop trying to force men to marry a man who cut off his junk who now calls himself a woman. She goes on. Be pro-choice, she says, and be vocal in support of reproductive rights. And generous, give to abortion funds. Understand that the opposite of reproductive choice is forced childbearing. Right. What better way to support and champion women than advocating to end the lives of hundreds of thousands of unborn women every year? Nobody is forcing anybody else to bear a child. If they are, please point that out to me so that I can stand with you against it. But where is that happening outside of polygamous compounds in the Islamic State Caliphate? Put down The Handmaid's Tale for 1 second. Welcome to reality. If you're not willing to accept the responsibility of sex, don't have sex. But don't pretend that killing the life of an unborn child is good for anybody. Then Ms. Rossner says, support subsidized birth control. Support non-taxed menstrual products. Ask your workplace if tampons and pads are free. Get over your embarrassment about menstruation. Okay, so Ms. Rossner, I assume, is one of the hashtag hands off my birth control crowd. But when government takes its hands off birth control, like she says she wants, like President Trump did when he rolled back the Obamacare contraceptive mandate and hands women the responsibility of their own birth control, she freaks out. She basically wants you men to take your hands off her pills and put them in your wallet to pay for her pills. Then Ms. Rossner says, men can be better feminists if you vocally advocate at your workplace for longer and more egalitarian paid parental leave, whether or not parenthood is part of your life. Advocate for lactation spaces. Advocate for on-site or subsidized childcare. Can you imagine a single dude, not a parent, in the office advocating for lactation spaces? Everybody would avoid that guy. Cultivate genuine, intimate, non-sexual friendships with women. And here Ms. Rossner identifies exactly why the majority of married women don't identify as modern progressive feminists, because feminists want your husband to have a lady BFF. We've got just a couple more here. Anytime you see a building, she says, street, institution, etc., named for a man, see how long it takes you to find a spot, another one named for a woman. And try not to get hit by a car while you participate in this useless activity. These are the things feminists actually think will make men be more like feminists. Ask yourself what you don't do, she says, for whatever reason that you also think of something women as something women tend to do. So, send birthday cards, care about skincare, try doing it for a while. And then when you've gotten in the habit of getting your nails done on a regular basis, expect these same feminists to complain about gender appropriation. But she's not done. Ms. Rossner says to be a better feminist, men should befriend children. And then blame Helen Rossner when the police arrest the creepy guy trying to make friends with kids in the park. Talk less, she says, in all spaces, at all times. Says the woman who spent 20 tweets telling men why they are so horrible. Okay, so this is clearly the dumbest list to hit the internet in a long time, maybe even since Hillary Clinton's list of 67 reasons why she lost, but none of them were her fault. Here's how you can actually be a better feminist. Be good, godly men. Be willing to give your life to protect the women you love and the women around you. Be proud of your country. Respect women. Advocate for women. Advocate for unborn women. Don't use abortion and abortifacient birth control as an excuse to treat women like sexual objects. Cherish who we are as women. Our fertility and our sexuality are part of that. Don't apologize for being a man. Most women love you because you are a man. Masculinity is not something to be ashamed of. You are not inherently sexist. You are inherently a man. Pass that on to your sons and protect the rights, the freedom, the liberty of all Americans. Of course that includes women. And ignore feminists who try to demean you for being men in order to push their bitter liberal agenda. And that's my final point. You can reach me on Twitter at Liz_Wheeler. If you liked the show, please send me an email at oann.com/contact. In the meantime, catch us here tomorrow at 9 p.m. Eastern. And until then, have a good night.